By the end of 1999, No Doubt could hardly recognise themselves. As if spending 27 months on the road wasn't enough, they also recorded tracks for the films Go and the Rugrats movie. On the personal front, Gwen celebrated her 30th birthday while Adrian got engaged.
It was an intense time. We were gone for so long, we had to like pick up our new lives, come home, and we found places to live, which was fun to do. And we actually took 2 months off. There's some fun thing we did. What was it? We bought cars, I think.
I was the only person in the band who bought a fire truck. Like, everyone else went and bought sports cars and, you know, like, luxury vehicles. I bought a fire truck.
He gets lots of chicks.
Girls love it.
No Doubt's third full-length album, Return of Saturn, was released in 2000.
Did you ever think of calling it Return of Saturn? No, we actually thought about calling it Return of Uranus. It's a different planet, and it has a whole different meaning. The record's a really good record to have sex to, and if you look at the different songs, Ex-Girlfriend's a kind of like a pumping, you know, you get rhythmical, yep. You know, and then Bathwater, you can have a little fun and games, you know what I mean? But when you get to the Too Late instrumental, it's where you're kind of, it's the end of the night, you're done, everyone's kind of like shot their load, you know what I mean?
Bit of pillow talk.
Yeah, and so that's time when you want to reflect and you want to just like look back on how great the night was, you know what I mean?
The album's first single, Ex-Girlfriend, sent tongues wagging. Was it about Gwen and Tony? Was it about Gwen and Gavin? Was Gwen the ex-girlfriend? Fueling further speculation over Gwen's lyrics was a comment Adrian made during an interview stating Tragic Kingdom was the album about Tony, while Return of Saturn was the album about Gavin.
This made it up just to make it sound interesting for the press.
Well, I think I do see this reoccurring subject of these love songs that keep popping up. I mean, it's not like I plan it or anything. It's just whatever I'm feeling. And I think what happens is when you focus so much, like 13 years of focus on this band and music, and I'm practically married to these guys. I have a serious commitment that I've made to them. Sometimes other things in my life have suffered, and I think one of those things might be the relationship here and there. So I think that theme just keeps reoccurring because it's the place in my life that is lost balance. So yeah, I think that, you know, my relationship that I've had for 4 years sometimes has been talked about in this record here and there. And last time it was talked about because, you know, it was like the first time I was writing songs for the most part, and it was after Tony and I had broken up, and, you know, I was just searching to express myself.
And as the story goes, once the album was out, it was time to start touring all over again.
I've been so nervous all day with a stomachache, and do I ever get nervous for shows? Never.
The greatest guitarist in the world.
Oh,
he's
hot.
Yeah.
When Stefani sees this, I just want her to know that I love her and I want to have all of her children.
She may be a superstar, but yes, even Gwen has her bad days.
I pretty much made the biggest mistake that I've made in probably my whole career so far. I was going great, everything was fine, stumbling over a few words here and there, and then all of a sudden the chorus came, and instead of going into the second half of the chorus, I went into the verse. I'm just embarrassed, and it's a shame because it could have been so great, and it's not even for me, really. It's for the rest of the guys. So I never really had the best show. But I still feel fortunate to be able to be asked to play this event, and I feel like I let down a lot of people, my friends and my band, but I think that they love me enough that they'll let me be in the band still.
Not until recently that I've looked back on our lives and said, wow, you know, we've really been committed to each other. I mean, a lot of the time in the early years, it was really just the passion that just kept us going, and it was like we kind of couldn't help ourselves. It was crazy because, all you know, we always knew, like, the girlfriends or boyfriends in the band were always going to be number two, and No Doubt's always number one. And it was, we were very strict about it just because we were passionate and we loved it.
Adding to her list of collaborations, Gwen followed up her hit with Moby by featuring on Eve's track, Let Me Blow Your Mind, which was produced by Eminem's right-wing man, Dr. Dre.
Who would have thought it would have gone blown up so big? I mean, it was so fun. And I just respect her a lot. You know, she's filling a huge role there, being, you know, a 21-year-old black female rapper in hip-hop, and some pretty huge shoes, and she's doing a great job. I feel lucky to be part of that project.
Meanwhile, back on the No Doubt trail, the band was gearing up to release their fourth studio album, Rocksteady.
We have just been in such a great space in the last year. We had an amazing year together on personal levels and band levels, friend level, creative levels. And I just think we feel really excited and proud of the record in that kind of way.
Recorded around the globe in San Francisco, LA, Jamaica, London and France, No Doubt worked with a diverse selection of producers and musicians.
We worked with Prince. He actually called for me to come sing on his last record. Was it the last record? Yeah. And in return, he said he would do something with us. So we had this track called Waiting Room that we had written that needed work. And he's like, well, send me the demo. And by the time we got off the plane, he had kind of like rewritten this whole song. And at the time we were doing Merchant of Saturn, it was like, our mouths were on the floor when we heard it. We were like, that is so wicked. But it didn't really fit into what we were doing. Return to Saturn was a real kind of organic record. It didn't, you know, I don't know, it was just ahead of its time. So we ended up pulling it out at the very last minute at this record, and we were like, this fits in exactly with this record.
And the Neptunes.
That whole thing was an experiment, and it was like us, after being a band for 15 years, we all kind of said, you know, if there was any interesting situations that came up where people wanted to work together with us, we would try it. Not for the record, not because we wanted to make a record, but just for the experience of it. But the whole idea was to come up with something really fresh, and we wrote a song called Hella Good together. The waves keep on crashing on me for some
reason. Most marriages don't even last 15 years these days. How do you stay together for that long and not want to punch each other?
Seems like it went by really, really fast.
Yeah.
You know, we were really young when the band started. I was 16, Gwen was 17, and, you know, here we are, like 15 years later, sitting in Australia doing interviews. It's just, it went really quick. We've had a really good time doing it. I think even through all the tough times, there was always something that was like something to look forward to.
It's just been like this extended childhood, and we're just totally trying to enjoy every second of it, because we know we're not at the beginning of our careers or middle of them. So it's pretty cool.
Next up, when we keep hanging with Gwen and No Doubt, Gwen kills off the band and goes it alone.